Now, before I begin, this is not an indictment against the mobile phone, meaning a claim that you should put your mobile phone away, throw away, or whatever it is. All it is illuminating a potential risk in adolescence, a correlation at this point in time, in regard to mobile phone use and a deficit in figural memory. We'll get more into that in a second. However, what is most important is that it may be a very, very simple issue to mitigate by doing something as simple as using a headset as opposed to putting a mobile phone next to your ear. And that's the main point here. Yes, we recognize a potential risk, very easy to fix, and then we move forward. But with that in mind, let's proceed into the research as follows. And also, the research is fully published, beautifully detailed. It'd make any biostatistician proud. They go into study after study after study, other studies per se, the linear regression, the whole lineup. It's a real study. So to proceed as follows. Mobile phone radiation may affect memory performance in adolescents. To narrate the first two paragraphs as follows. The rapid evolution of information and communication technologies goes a long way with an increase in exposure to radio frequency electromagnetic fields, henceforth RF-EMF, in our daily life. The most relevant exposure source to the brain is the use of a mobile phone close to the head. Several studies have been conducted to identify potential health effects related to RF-EMF, though results have remained inconclusive. The research conducted by scientists at the Swiss Tropical and Public Health Institute looked at the relationship between exposure to RF-EMF from wireless communication devices and memory performance in adolescents. The study follows up a report published in the Scientific Journal Environmental International in 2015 with twice the sample size in more recent information on the absorption of RF-EMF in adolescents' brains during types of wireless communication device use. The one in 2015 and now, are the world's first epidemiological studies to estimate the cumulative RF-EMF brain dose in adolescents. So, what do they mean? The best way to give an example is what they're doing in regard to figural memory, nonverbal memory per se. For the figural memory task, this gives you at least a little bit of perspective, participants were given 1 minute to memorize 13 pairs of abstract figures, and immediately afterward, one item per pairs was shown, and participants were asked to choose the correct counterpart out of the five possible options. You can find a lot of examples of these figural memory tasks online. But this just gives you in a perspective the question they were asking, and this is where the scores began to decline. Now, the sample group as follows. Basically, the data gathered from the health effects related to mobile phone use in adolescents, HERMES, cohort looked at the relationship between exposure to RF-EMF and the development and memory performance of almost 700 adolescents over the course of 1 year. Pretty good sample size. Participants were aged 12 to 17 years. It's important, so when you hear the word adolescent, you get an idea of what they mean by adolescent. Were recruited from the 7th to 9th public school grades in urban and rural areas of Swiss German-speaking Switzerland. The results. The study to be published on, which we already has, because we're a little bit past July 19th, 2018, found that cumulative RF-EMF brain exposure from mobile phone use over 1 year, we're talking 1 year, that's a real short period of time, which could be exacerbated due to the fact these are adolescents or children who are still growing brain-wise and otherwise, may have a negative effect. I want to emphasize the word may. We're looking at a correlation, more mobile phone use, a greater decline in figural memory. Doesn't mean it's a causal yet, but it looks correlative. Big difference in that terminology there. Negative effect on development and figural memory performance in adolescents, confirming prior results published in 2015. Confirmation study. Figural memory is mainly located in the right brain hemisphere. Remember that part, right brain hemisphere, because I'm going to show you a little chart right after this. An association with RF-EMF was more pronounced in adolescents using the mobile phone on the right side of the head. This may suggest that indeed, RF-EMF absorbed by the brain are responsible for the observed associations. So right hemisphere, figural memory. All right, let's cut straight to the chart as follows. You see the little thing I have there in regard to the arrow and the line? All right, the little dot there, if you go to the end of the line there, you see the little circle, means right ear preference in regard to using the cell phone. And if you notice, the deficit or the change in score in regard to figural memory is pointed out to be the greatest deficit in those that use a cell phone on the right ear, hence right hemisphere, hence potential reason for the drop in figural memory. However, again, as daunting as this may appear, there may be extremely simple solutions. That's why I wanted to do the video, because it could be a very, very simple potential outcome to mitigate. As follows, minimizing the risk of RF-EMF exposure, the potential effect of RF-EMF, again, quoting, exposure to the brain is a relatively new field of scientific inquiry. It is not yet clear how RF-EMF could potentially affect brain process or how relevant, quoting the researchers, our findings are in the long term. Potential risks to the brain can be minimized by using headphones or the loudspeaker while calling, in particular when network quality is low and mobile phone is functioning at maximum power. You see what I mean? Yeah, there may be an issue in regard to cell phone use, at least a correlation at this point in time, but extremely, extremely simple to mitigate it, provided the issue is looked at, illuminated, and therefore countered. Again, beautiful research. Give them more example of the data that we have it here. I really encourage looking at the full study. It is free to the public to look at, and it really has been done well and in detail. A lot of reading, but they wanted to make sure they covered all the bases. Again, this is Ralph Trajano signing off once again. Thank you very much for listening. Hope you find this information of use. DOI citation will be there for you to follow. And as always, thank you. Catch you next time. Bye.